Top 5 Mysteries of the Aryans. Aryan is perhaps the most controversial term in archaeology. Originally a self-identifier of the Indo-Iranian people, Aryan referred to a cultural and linguistic group, not an ethnicity. 19th-century scholars misappropriated the term, made it a synonym for all Indo-Europeans, and burdened it with racial connotations never intended by the original users. Of course, we all know how Adolf Hitler abused the concept to carry out his racist policies as he tried to achieve world domination. Yet, despite his defeat in World War II, the record has not been set straight. To this day, misinformation about Aryans abounds. 5. The last pure Aryans. Hidden away in Kashmir's Himalayan highlands, the Brogpas claim to be the last pure Aryans. Cloistered in a few villages at a 3,000-meter (10,000 feet) elevation in the Aryan Valley, the Brogpas have remained isolated culturally and genetically for centuries. In the past, visitors were unwelcome and outside marriages were strictly prohibited. Endogamy and oral tradition preserved what some believe are archaic traits of the Aryan ancestors. In 2010, the Indian government made a push to open these mountain villages to tourists. The Brogpas are generally taller than their Tibeto-Mongolian neighbors and have Mediterranean features and fair skin, with occasional blonde hair and light eyes. Their origin remains unknown. One legend holds that they are the remnants of Alexander the Great's army. In 2007, filmmaker Sanjeev Sivan released The Akdung Baby, In Search of Purity. The documentary follows German women who seek to become impregnated by the pure Aryans of the Himalayan highlands. 4. The caste system. Oral tradition traces the origin of India's caste system to the arrival of Aryans into the subcontinent around 1500 BC. Scholars have long believed that the system of class hierarchy was set in place to formalize relationships between the new arrivals and the indigenous inhabitants, whom they considered inferior. The usage of the words dasis or dasi, both of which translate to slaves, suggests that the system may have grown out of an enslavement of the region's indigenous inhabitants. The caste system is composed of 4 classifications based on occupation. Brahmins, priests, occupy the top. Following them are the Kshatriyas, warriors. Below them are the merchants and farmers known as Vaishyas. At the bottom of the pyramid are the Sudras, laborers. The Indian word for caste is Varna, color. This lends credence to the fact that the lighter-skinned Aryans use this system as a means to oppress the region's darker aboriginal inhabitants. 3. Unearthed Aryan cities. In 2010, Russian archaeologists announced the discovery of ancient Aryan cities on the southern Siberian steppe. Dated to 4,000 years ago, these 20 spiral-shaped settlements rivaled the size of Greek city-states and were each designed to house 1,000 to 2,000 individuals. The cities were first explored over 2 decades ago. However, their remote locations have made them virtually unknown until recently. Experts believe that there may be as many as 50 more settlements to be discovered, along with evidence of structures. Researchers also unearthed equipment, chariots, horse burials, and pottery. Swastikas cloak many of the objects. This ancient symbol of the sun and eternal life was long associated with the Aryans before its appropriation by the Nazis. While these settlements are definitely Indo-European, there is no direct evidence that these were the individuals who went on to settle northern India. The usage of Aryan in this context carries significant social and political implications. 2. Aryan Iran. In 1935, Reza Shah Pahlavi officially requested foreign delegates to use the name Iran for his country instead of the traditional name Persia. Many believe that the name Iran means land of the Aryans. The name originally derives from the old Persian word Arya or Ariya, which was a self-designation of the Indo-European-speaking inhabitants of the area. This is a cognate for the Sanskrit word Arya from which Aryan emerges. In 1862, scholar Max Müller claimed that Iran means Aryan expanse. However, the racial connotations of this reflect a fundamental lack of understanding. In Old Persian, Arya referred to speakers of a language, not a race. According to historian Grarto Nolai, Ariya was not an ethnicity but the term used to connote a king's legitimacy. The closest translation would be noble. He states that the term Aryanam Vija, from which the name Iran derives, is actually a cosmogonic concept from Zoroastrianism. 1. Aryan homeland. After long debate about the location of the Aryan homeland, scholars now look to the steppe between the Black and Caspian Seas. Experts refer to the Bronze Age culture of Central Asian pastoralists as the Amnaiya. With their wheeled chariots, pit craves, an Indo-European language, the Amnaia spread their culture and genes east and west. There is no definitive archaeological evidence to connect the Amnaia to the subcontinent. Elsewhere, pit graves and ceramics provide clear signs of these pastoralists. However, in India, archaeological remains from the cultural transition between the Indus Valley civilization and the Vedic era are scant. It would be a mistake to refer to the Amnaia as Aryans. At this time, it is impossible to say whether these Central Asian nomads were the ones who brought Indo-European culture to the subcontinent. However, it does point to the Pontic-Caspian steppe as the birthplace of Indo-European languages and culture.